So was the case less about punishing Goldman and more about getting the reform bill passed by painting Goldman Sachs as the poster child for all that might be wrong with Wall Street?
Perhaps just a coincidence, but the bill passed, and hours later the settlement was announced. Congresswoman Michelle Bachmann, Republican of Minnesota, is here with us in studio. Great to see you, Congresswoman.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Now, what do you think? What do you make of this whole Goldman Sachs settlement?
Well, I think you'd be very happy that you own Goldman stock today. You know, sometimes it looked like it wasn't such a good thing and investors were headed for the exits, but people who held on to the stock are very happy today.
But talk about the theory that interesting how the FinReg bill was passed and then just a bit later we saw that there was a settlement with the SEC. Now, you would talk to people inside the Beltway, at least in the administration, they would say there's absolutely no relation. Do you disagree?
Well, a person can't know. I mean, there's no evidence. It certainly looks like a very interesting coincidence, however, when you look at the timing, and timing, of course, is everything. But I think knowing it wasn't a sure thing that these votes would be there for the financial reform bill. Scott Brown, was inkling one way or another. But I think once it was clear that the votes were in hand, all the other pieces fell into place.
Well, now the campaign moves to the fall, of course, and financial regulation will be the rule and the law of the land by then as it goes to the president's desk for his signature. What's wrong with it, in your view? Republicans did not support it except for the few that you mentioned. What's wrong with it? What's the problem? What's the biggest problem?
Well, I think the biggest problem is that it's going to hurt people on Main Street. Of course, the people who caused the problem need to have handcuffs on, so
but
to
in
speak.
What way?
But that's Freddie and Fannie, and of course, they were absent from the bill. Here's what the problem will be, though. People on Main Street immediately are going to see bye-bye to free checking. Number two, we're going to see increase in ATM fees. That will hit everyone. And then after that, I think we're going to see a difficult time to access credit for people, both small businesses and individuals. That impacts people on Main Street, and they were looking to slap up people on Wall Street, but it's people on Main Street that are going to pay a very big price.
Representative, nothing could hurt the American public more than what we went through due to crazy risk
behavior.
By
comparison, but that's not gone. That's the problem.
Well, by comparison, though, and if you talk to Gary Gensler, of which we did, the Commodities Futures Trading Commission, to at least take that portion that was a wild market, certainly, with no collateral required to take crazy bets, and then when they unwound, it became a taxpayer problem, to at least start to make sure that there is some type of, kryptonite put around that so it doesn't happen again. Is that not more valuable than, okay, so I don't get free checking?
Well, it depends on who you're talking to. Because if you're talking to someone who free checking means everything to them and access to credit means everything and then also the ATM fees mean everything, that will impact them immediately. And that's a good segment of the voting population. I would absolutely agree with you. No one disagrees that there were bad guys. No one disagrees that there was bad behavior and that needed to be reined in. Part of the problem is that the Community Reinvestment Act still lives, and the Community Reinvestment Act is a big part of this problem, as were Fannie and Freddie. But interestingly, they're completely absent from the bill.
But it doesn't sound like you would have done nothing as opposed to something. So what would have been done in place of this then? If this bill wasn't the right thing, Fannie and Freddie, you think they missed.
Fannie and Freddie dramatically needed to have reform. And rather than conservatorship, I think receivership would have been the way to go. And also, I think it was a big mistake for Treasury Secretary Tim Geithner to have an unlimited cap on taxpayer monies going into Freddie and Fannie. And that was a Christmas gift that was given, as you recall.
So what else besides Fannie and Freddie?
Well, the Community Reinvestment Act. I think that's an effort that, in my mind, needs drastic reform because that very clearly led to the excesses with Freddie and Fannie. People were sounding the alarm, by the way, and Freddie and Fannie, nothing was done.
You are not the only one. There are so many people who are livid that Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac were not included in this because it is a huge problem.
Yes, you're right.
Can the Republicans come out with a plan about dealing with that, put it forth and say, come on, now we tackle this?
No, absolutely. I think that's exactly what Republicans need to do because what we want to do is have a sound financial basis. We need to have certainty.
Can you get any Democrats on board with that? Have you set up a few?
There are reasonable pro-business Democrats that I think that we could get on board because this is a bipartisan effort. Yeah. It's about stabilizing the economy. I've done one job for them after another in my district in Minnesota, and the one thing I hear, whether it's a large business or small business, is certainty. People are frantic because everything's uncertain. People want certainty. Now that the bill is passed, you might say that there's a measure of certainty. But it's certainty about credit seizing up, certainty that higher fees will go into place. So I think we can have a better reform package than the one that
it's interesting to hear you use the term bipartisan effort.
I think we can.
Because the criticism of your party, you're well aware of it, is that it's been the party of no.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the campaign.
But it's been a false charge because we have had one reform bill after another. Unfortunately, mm-hmm. the Democrat majority, particularly under Chairman Frank and Chairman Dodd, they have rejected a multitude of Republican reform.
We think that Americans want to see bipartisanship.
Absolutely.
Do you hear that too?
Absolutely. I think that they do. And more than anything, Americans want us to get back to job recovery. That's job number one for the
right.
Congress is job recovery, because it's a very real consequence for families.
But not by extending unemployment benefits?
Pardon me?
But not by extending unemployment benefits?
Well, part of the problem now is unemployment benefits are already 99 weeks long. That's
right.
Almost 2 years of unemployment. People don't want necessarily an unemployment check. What they want is a job.
Job.
So we have to have a pro-growth, pro-job equation.
Thanks
for coming
in.
Hey, thanks.